Please don't forget to subscribe to my channel and click on the bell icon to get more of these no-nonsense nutrition videos. Hi everyone, I'm Amrita and welcome to my channel Fries and Shine. Here you will find evidence-based, no-nonsense nutrition-related information. And today's video is about 5 easy ways to increase fat loss. Everyone seems to be obsessed with losing excess fat these days. Whether it's because it's going to reduce risk of diseases like type 2 diabetes and heart disease, or whether it's because one is trying to achieve an aesthetic goal, most referrals to dietitians these days are to help with meal plans for fat loss. Actually, most referrals are for weight loss, but people really mean fat loss because we never really want to lose either muscle weight or bone weight. And why has it become so hard to lose fat? Perhaps because we have very easy access to food and far too little physical activity in comparison. Also, with so much food and nutrition information now available on the internet, it has become very confusing about what really needs to be done in order to lose fat. So in this video, I'm going to round up 5 easy tips that I think are extremely important when it comes to fat loss and increasing fat loss. Number 1, eat more home-cooked food. This one is really important because here, you are in control. You are in charge of the quality of the ingredients used as well as the quantity of the food that you eat. Restaurants tend to serve very large servings of food, and it's very possible that you'll end up eating more than you would normally eat because of this. Restaurants also batch prep food. This means that they make large quantities of food that they then use throughout the day. They use excess oil and excess salt to prepare this food so that it cooks quicker and lasts longer. Now, this oil and salt can add extra calories to the meal, and the excess salt can also make you retain water, which would impact both your body fat levels as well as your weight. So to sum up, eating at home allows you to control quality of the ingredients, quantity of food eaten, how much oil goes into your food, and how much salt goes into your food, all of which can help you control calories and in this way impact fat loss. Number 2, eat more protein. Of all the 3 macronutrients, that is carbohydrates, protein and fat, protein keeps you the fullest for the longest amount of time. And if you're feeling full, you won't constantly need to eat, will you? So chances are your overall calorie intake may decrease throughout the day, creating a caloric deficit. And to make up for this caloric deficit, your body will dip into stored fat to get the calories. And this is how you end up losing fat. So make sure that you are eating protein-rich food at main meals and at your snack times. How much protein do you need? Check my video out right here to learn about that. Number 3, eat more fiber. Not only is fiber a magical ingredient for health, but it can also do wonders to help you lose fat. Fiber is a kind of carbohydrate that our body does not digest. What this means is that when you eat fiber, it passes through your entire digestive system and comes out as stool because your body is not able to digest it and extract any energy or calories from it. What does fiber help with then? Well, fiber adds bulk to your food. Think of vegetables, a food group really rich in fiber. Think of a whole bowl of salad. Even this very large bowl of salad will give you hardly any calories as compared to, say, a slice of bread and butter. The salad bowl looks large but has fewer calories. The bread and butter looks compact but has more calories. This is simply because of the quality of food. Vegetables are full of fiber and add volume and bulk to your meals. And most of us like to look at a really full plate when we eat, right? So make sure that at meal times, at least half your plate is full of non-starchy vegetables. For more details on how to create a perfectly balanced plate at meal times, check my video linked right here. Number 4, Incorporate strength training into your workout. Strength or resistance training is an excellent way to speed up fat loss. The advantage of this form of exercise is that it allows you to build up more muscle and bone over time. And the more muscle and bone you have, the quicker you can lose weight and lose fat. Think of athletes. Most of them have a high muscle mass, which allows them to keep burning fat even when they are simply resting. Muscle mass naturally declines with age, so that if you are 50-50 muscle versus fat at age 30, you might be 40-60 muscle over fat over time. The only way to maintain your fat loss is to maintain muscle mass. And the only way to do this is to eat a well-balanced diet with enough protein and carbohydrates and to make sure that you regularly strength train. And this is for all ages, no matter how old or young. Number 5, focus on sleep. Sleep more to lose more fat? Surely this is absurd. Actually, you burn a fair number of calories when you're sleeping because your body is still working to keep you alive. In fact, depending on how long you've been sleeping, you move through different phases of sleep. And REM sleep, you actually burn a lot of calories in REM sleep. And all of your body's repair work and muscle building work happens when you are asleep. And we just finished discussing how we want maximum muscle to make sure that we're getting maximum fat loss. So imagine, sleeping more can actually help regulate hormones, repair tissues, and build muscle in a way that you can burn more fat when you are awake. For more issue on how sleep can help fat loss, check my video linked right here. Fat loss does not have to be complicated, and these 5 simple steps can really help you. Do any of these sound surprising to you? Leave in the comments below. That's all for today. I hope you enjoyed this video and found it helpful. If you did, please remember to like, share and subscribe to my channel and share this video with others who will also find it helpful. If you have any questions or concerns, you can leave them in the comments below, send me an email or reach out to me on Instagram. I hope to hear from you very soon. Until then, take care and keep shining.